Stage. And Iran, well, they've had three wins, including one against Bosnia and Herzegovina. 3-0 in Pool B. So the teams are just preparing now, having a few final words from the coaches before we see them come out for their national anthems. The crowd, well, they're in force this evening as we've got Brazil. Home crowd are going to be going crazy. I think there's going to be a lot of noise here. The teams are lining up, ready to be presented and have the national anthems played.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the Islamic Republic of Iran.
Señores y señores, o hino da República Islâmica do Irã.
And now, the anthem of Brazil.
E agora, o hino do Brasil.
Anthem's over for both countries. A very special moment when you get to represent your country in any sport and have the anthem played out. Certainly gets the adrenaline flowing, the goosebumps as well. Can be quite emotional for some players. And actually being able to cope with that, all part and parcel of being an international athlete. So the anthem's over, the players to the benches. We're going to meet the referees in charge of this one. And the first referee today from Croatia is Dominik Rača.
The first referee from Croatia, Dominik Rača.
And he will be ably assisted by China's Han Qi. So it will be the Islamic Republic of Iran who will come out onto court first. Going to start with Morteza Mirzad, player number two. Mirzad Sel Akhagjani is full surname, playing through the outside. Masiam Alipour, number three, also an outside hitter. Setting is Davud Alipourian, the captain, number four, middle blocking. Is Sadej Bigdeli, number seven. Number eight is Majid Lashkari, also a setter. And through the outside is Zihari, number 10. The libero is Ramazan Salih. And the head coach, Hadi Razi Kakani. Razi Kakani waves to the crowd, the team are up and ready and waiting. The team that took the silver medal in London 2012, and they were beaten by Bosnia and Herzegovina by 3-1. They'll be hoping to make it back to the final, but in their way are Brazil, and they get out onto court now. Morteza looks on as player number one. Lourenço da Silva comes out. Giba, as he's known, that's a very popular Brazilian volleyballer. Levi Gomez, number two. Wellington da Silva, Wellington as he's known, number nine. And Renato de Oliveira, Renato, the setter as he has on his shirt. Wesley de Oliveira, Wesley as he's known, the middle blocker, number 11. And Anderson, Ribas da Silva, number 12. Anderson as he has on his shirt. The libero is Rodrigo, number four. And the head coach is Fernando Lages Guimares. So certainly a few familiar names when you think about Brazilian volleyball in terms of Giba, Rodrigão, Anderson and Guimarães. And this is the sitting volleyball team hoping to go and make it into the final, just as their volleyball compatriots did at the Maracanazinho at the Olympic Games. So the second referee checking the rotations, Brazil in white, Iran in green. And once that is successful, so Rodrigo will come in for Levi, is waiting to leave. Iran are all ready. Second referee now will check the scorers' table that they're happy, which they are. And the ball will go to the serving team. Oh, well, that's going to be an issue now because the serving team is Brazil. So that is now going to be reversed. The Libero goes back off, so Levi can come on and serve. Just checking who the captain on court is. And we're almost ready to go.
The loser of tonight's match will take on Egypt in the bronze medal match. The winner of the match tonight will take on Bosnia for gold.
O perdedor do jogo dessa noite vai pegar o Egito pela medalha de bronze e o vencedor vai para a medalha de ouro.
Well, the teams are now ready, and so is the referee. Iran playing in green, Brazil playing in white. And Brazil to serve first. This is the semi-final match for the men's sitting volleyball at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. First point to Brazil.
And a huge roar, which kind of sets the tone for the way this match is going to go. Every time Brazil score a point, It's going to be deafening here at Rio Centro 6. But that's what they're going to have to contend with, although that has gone against Iran, lifting cord as Mirzad put that ball on the floor. How do you stop that? He's over the top of the block. And when you look at his stats, it says he spikes the ball at 2.30 meters. When you think about it, you think, well, that can't be possible. But he is 2.40 meters in height. And he's, the net is 1.15 meters. When he sat there, his head is above the net, so it puts him at about at 1.20, 1.30. And with his arm above his head, which is more than a metre long, he is at 2.30 meters. And he's almost impossible to stop, isn't he? This time, Iran have their first point. But again, it's that man, Mirzad, over the top. That might have been going out, actually. Brazil played it. I'll be wishing they hadn't. So lifting now called against Brazil. Renato, the guilty party.
So Apurian to serve at 2-2. So nice spike from number 10, Renato.
Well, Renato's going to have a difficult match against Mirzad, but he has to come up with shots like that, be clever around the big block that Mirzad had. He's one of the few players in sitting volley who can get his hands right across the net and get really close to contacts of the other team. Well, Brazil wanted a carry for that play, not being given, and they still keep it off the floor. Iran, another chance here for Brazil. Well, that is a huge block. Mirzad it was. Well, what he might be lacking in technique, he more than makes up for in the fact that he can get so close to the ball.
He's lacking in experience, so every game that he plays now, he'll be building in confidence. And there's a ball that has gone a long way out. Well, that's a free point to Brazil. Giba to serve at 4-3.
Well, that one's not caught the sideline. Line judge says out. No one's touched it. Point for Brazil. They lead by two. Well, Iran know this is not going to be easy coming into this situation. Rio Centro 6 packed to the rafters with Brazilian supporters cheering their team on. Their job is to try and keep them quiet with their volleyball, which they have done, which means we can hear them celebrate.
That's right, the crowd are going to go quiet, I think, every time we see an Iranian score. Lovely spike. Got the block out. Now 4-5. There's out to serve. Serve is unsuccessful.
She had backspin on that serve.
So Wesley to serve. Oh, huge spike coming in. And that was from Big Deli. And he made it count, didn't he?
Super fast play in the middle. No one ready for that because he passed the ball and then he shuffled in, legally so, according to the referees, to have the spike. Double touch called against Brazil.
So Lashkari to serve, 6 apiece. Straight into the net. Well, that's another 3 point to Brazil. Takes them to 7-6. just a roll over the blockers. It's enough to put the Brazilians out of kilter. Scores are tied.
All just catching the antenna. One thing we're seeing from Iran, they're not just relying on Mirzad. This isn't about having one player who can hit the ball above what anyone else can block. And they're not relying on him solely for what they're doing. They have the lead at the first technical timeout. It's a good team effort from Iran. That's put him in this position.
Lovely block by number 10, Zirahi. But the scores are now at level 8 apiece. So Wellington to serve at 8-all.
Sometimes it does look like one team has won the point, but because of the lifting rule, it can be penalised, even though they have won the point. Not something that, when we're watching the game, you're going to be looking for, because we're following the ball, watching the plays. And again, it's another call here against Iran. This time, though, it's a net touch. And they're all looking at the ref to say, well, I didn't touch it.
So Wellington serving now, a point up. Kept live by Brazil.
Nice pick up from the libero.
That was a big spike, and that takes Iran now to 9-all.
Well, even though the ball had gone long, because it hit the Brazilian block on its way out, Iran it is who take the point. Good D. Brazil putting a defender right into the corner, down at 5, getting a good view of the court, but unfortunately the libero for Brazil, Rodrigo, couldn't then go and get the ball.
Well left by the Iranians. That spike from Jiba goes out of play. He continues to serve at 11-9. A lovely block from Alpurian. So a timeout has been called by Brazil. Allowed to make two timeout calls during each set. Maybe a technical timeout at 8 and 16 points also. So Zerahi to continue serving. 12-9. Lovely block from Mehrzad.
See his ability to get up and also get across and get close to the ball. Great celebration from him.
It's got to be intimidating playing opposite. He's such an overtowering figure. Substitution, Rodrigo Libero has come off in place of Levy, who is going to serve.
Well watched by Anderson, by Jeeber. It was keeping his hands up at the net to stop Iran going over on two. However, it's an infringement by Brazil. Iran have a 4-point lead now.
So Alepurian to serve. For Iran at 14-10. And a point to Brazil.
Net touch by Mehrzad on the near side, closer to the second referee, spotted by the first referee furthest away. Double movement from Mehrzad. Really, he's that tall. He can just put his hand straight across in front of him almost in one movement. That's what he probably should be aiming to do. Keep that his arms probably parallel with his shoulders. Try and get his hands on the ball just after the Brazil touch it themselves. So lifting called against Iran. And Brazil now getting right back into this one.
Renato to serve, 12-14. Oh, lovely block from Mehrzad. That's going to give Iran another point. So Alipur now to serve, 15-12. Spike by Mehrzad, blocked by Brazil. Well, it didn't even go over the net, did it?
It wasn't in a good position for him. It was way to his left, and he was having to lean across his body to get to the ball.
Jiba to serve. Wow.
That's the set that he wants, the ball coming. Nice and high. They don't have to worry about disguising anything when they go to Mehrzad. A high ball out to him so that drops right over his right shoulder and then he can do what he wants with it. So the technical timeout, Iran lead by three. I was fortunate enough to be chatting to Ashley Trodden, the assistant coach to the GB women's sitting team from London 2012, talking about the fact that this game that was coming up where Brazil beat Iran for the first time ever back at the World Championships. And Iran said at the time, well, we don't mind this loss because Brazil don't know what's coming. and they were referring to Mirzad, who was just been discovered and coming into the team, and he certainly is making a difference here in this tournament for Iran. But fair play to Brazil, they are by no means intimidated by what they have to do to try and stop Mirzad. Their volleyball is pretty good at the moment, and they're getting exactly what they need. Nice block out, bringing themselves back to within two. Mirzad's only a threat when he's at the net. There's three rotations when he goes to the back row and then goes off the court. Brazil right now very much in this match. Get it back this time. There you go, block out off of Levi. It's a fine line. You think you can go up and have a swing and you've got that space, you can go steep with the ball, but even though the block's not getting across the net, if you do go steep and get that angle and it hits the block, it's going to come straight back down your own side.
Lashkari to serve, 18-14.
Did that catch a hand? Iran thinks so. Brazil are never going to admit to it. It's not up to them to admit to it. It's up to the lines judges to see it, and it didn't catch anybody.
So Anderson to serve now for Brazil, 15-18.
That is a huge block from Brazil. Levi was all over that. Nowhere for Zirahi to go. Another big block from Brazil. Just 1 point in it, the crowd going wild here at Rio Centro 6. Iran are being kept very quiet.
Anderson again. 1 point game. A big spike. And it's successful this time. Alpurian really hits it hard. Gets a touch as it goes out. So Big Deli to serve. Still in.
Fans thought it hit the floor. They might have to think again here. No, they don't now. It has hit the floor. Brazil take the point. The looks on the faces of the Iranian players saying the game plan's not quite working at the moment.
There's only one thing that's changed. It's replacement of Mirzad. Oh, maybe they're going to be bringing him back on shortly. Oh, was that in or was that long? It was in. And there is the change that we were talking about. Mirzad back on now. What difference his height may make.
Yeah, the substitution was made in the back row just to give a little bit more potency to their defense in the back row. Now they're going to try and do that in the front with Mirzad. Something that is very noticeable about him is his ability to move very, very quickly laterally along the net for such a big guy. But it's another point for Brazil here. They still are trailing. That one not finding the baseline. So Wesley's back onto court for Brazil. There's going to be a timeout called here by Iran.
Lovely spike from Mehrzad. Unable to be kept in play by Brazil. The score now 22-19. So, Ascari is off. Golestani is on. Alpurian to serve, 2 points away from the first set. The timeout has been called.
Well, that was the block from Iran. Equally, the blocking of Brazil has been very good as well. You see Iran go with a late block. They're waiting to pounce, they're not trying to make it easy for Brazil by allowing them to see where the hands are early.
Purian to serve, 23-19. Now 24 for lifting against Brazil. 1 point away now from the first set. Well, that service straight into the net gives away a 3 point to Brazil. It's a 4 point game. It's still set point. So Renato to serve, 20-24. Well, a huge spike from Alipour, and that is the first set. Iran take the first set to take the lead here in Rio.
It was a great reverse set from Alipurian. Really good setter, distributing the ball beautifully. Iran getting it down through two. They take the first set 25-20 and lead 1-0. And it's now back to the drawing board for Brazil. Confirmation of that first set score. looking at the set statistics. Blocking wise, not much in it actually. Iran just 4-3. But service faults for Iran, 5-0. They're going to have to do better in the second set. Considering they won by 5, if they hadn't have made 5 serving errors, they may have won by 10. You can see it's rocking here in Rio Centro, and the fans jumping up and down, so too is the camera. One thing is for sure, the host Brazil have plenty of support here. Cut out some of their unforced errors. They could well take this next set.
So Iran to serve to get the second set underway. It's Iran currently leading by 1-0. Well, Big Deli served. The first point to Iran.
That ball going off the block and out of play. In fact, actually, as it came off of the defender, it just seemed to have clipped the block, so it had to be played. It was going to land in anyway. Nice work. Another good example of Iran with their late blocking, inviting Brazil to go for court. There's no hands there, and all of a sudden they pop up just as Fred's about to have a hit. Fred's just saying, come on, they're hopping up to make this block whilst they're doing that. Looking for a touch. Well, the one thing that Brazil can't rely on here are the lines judges in trying to get the decisions for them. The line's just saying it's come off the block, but that's a guide. It doesn't mean that the referee has to take that as what actually happened. The referee has to make his own mind up. The line judges are there to help.
Big Deli to serve, 3-0. Nice block from Alipour. Time out being called by Brazil early on in this second set. Big Delhi to serve, 4-0. Another block by Alapourian. Got a very disgruntled Egyptian team at the moment that claiming that there's lifting going on. So a carry has been called against the Brazilians. We're now at 6-0.
This is not the start that they wanted for this second set, having lost the first.
So at last, Brazil get themselves on the score sheet in the second set.
Well, Fernando Guimarães, the head coach for Brazil, will be a little bit pleased with that. And I did mention he has a very familiar surname to his counterpart for Brazilian volleyball, and it's familiar because it's his brother, Roberto Guimarães, the head coach of the women's Brazilian volleyball team, who competed here at the Rio Olympics. Very successful team, although they did miss out on medals this time around. So another point. You can just see that block from Marza, just waiting. He's not putting his hands up early, not being a target. He's waiting, pouncing.
Timing was impeccable.
It's quite a good tactic, but I'm kind of still tempted to say to him, get across, get your hands as close to that ball as possible. With his big hands that he's got, very difficult for them to do anything because he'd be literally an inch from the ball. But it's still working the way he's doing what he's doing. And at 8-1 and a technical timeout, this couldn't have come sooner for Brazil.
Nice spike, and it's a good point for Iran. Mirzad just puts that ball to the ground.
Not the best of contacts, came off his fingertips, but still the ball went down. Still no one could get anywhere near it. Well, Anderson's the tallest player for Brazil. They want to try and get that line up now so that he is up blocking against Mirzad. And then they want to put the ball anywhere but where Mirzad is blocking. Which is why they've gone out to four to Anderson, and he gets the block out, going through the middle. No, it's landed in court. It looked initially like it might have gone wide. Has in fact caught the line.
Well, big celebrations from Ali Poor. Another timeout called now, this time by Brazil.
Brazil going to make a substitution, see whether or not they can change their fortunes. Wesley's come in, so a little bit more height at the net. as good as he is sometimes, just like everybody else, capable of making mistakes. That ball was a little bit too far in front and he was back towards the 3 metre line. Certainly Brazil will make sure they don't serve anywhere near where Mirzad is, and that's a great block from the home team as they try and rally themselves to get back into this one.
A combination of Levi and Anderson forming the block at the net, and it's Wellington to serve at 4-10.
Well, serving fault has been given by Wellington, who was over the line, touching the line when he served the ball with his pelvis.
So Alipurian now to serve at 11-4. Big hit from Anderson, doesn't find the ground. Alipurian to save, Anderson to dig. And the second attempt, big spike from Anderson.
Well, Iran are convinced that that was a net touch by Brazil as they spiked that ball. Coach was going crazy. Nothing wrong with any of this, but as it comes back over, there's a massive net touch. That wasn't the ball that touched the net.
Brazil just pulling a few points back now. We're at 6-11 in the second set. First set went to Iran. Anderson to serve.
A little bit of jostling at the net going, oh, that was a little bit naughty. Iran won't be too pleased with that. What was going on under the net was Wesley was kicking at Mirzad to get him out of the way. That ball, though, everyone's watching the ball, seems to have hit the antenna from Iran. They're saying no. It all gets a little bit tasty at the net. Cards have been issued.
Sure. 13-6, it's Alipur that continues to serve.
It was indeed Guimaraes, the man who got the yellow card for his protestations after that last play. Everybody cheering, making the referee's job very difficult, has to go with what he's seen. He said that came off of Iran and out of play. That was a huge hit.
Well, Big Deli really nailed that one. Huge spike, found the gap between the defence. There was nobody there.
Right through the arms of Ziba. You can't believe that. Well, Mirzad still, as we mentioned earlier, still learning the game, really. He's a natural talent. He has great abilities with his spiking and his blocking. He moves really quickly to get in position, but still yet to get some of the finer arts mastered. But that will come with time.
Well, Levi to serve, 8-14.
So carry called off of the serve, the ball staying in the hand too long. This is good from Brazil. They're right back in this now. 10-1 at one point, now to 14-9. They have won 8-4 in the context of the passage of play. And now make that 9-4 as the errors are coming thick and fast here from Iran.
Levi to continue serving. 4-point game. And there is the big spike. Number 10, that's Zirami. Big shape up, goes for the gap. Giba unable to get a hand on it. So Ashkari to serve.
That's a lovely roll, cross-court by Wellington.
So Wesley now at 11-15. Oh, and it goes long. No movement at all on the Iranian side. Technical timeout now.
Iran leading 16-11. So substitution, Fabrizio is coming in. Chiba is going out. Still Iran with the lead. 5 points clear, 1-0 up. Fabrizio in to serve.
Brazil have got the point. The ball has gone to ground.
Confusion for Iran as to who was going to play that after it hit the block. Great serving from Fabrizio. Look at that, trying to get the team riled up here. 2 points in a row from him. A timeout called by Iran. Interesting looking at that, didn't look like a carry, it was a volley double touch. That that should be really allowed. A double touch on the serves, not a problem. Hardly anything in it at the moment, except for the fact that Iran have been better with the spiking.
Lovely blocking. But it's the lifting against Iran that's been given. Well, the hips. Number three, that's Ali Pour just coming off the ground. So serving now at 15-17. Fabrizio really coming on and injecting some oomph in the Brazilians. Full of energy and enthusiasm. Coming straight back at the body. Not much that could be done to return. Maybe should have had the hands up a little quicker. Big Deli in a spot of bother. And that one finds the gap.
Nice quick play behind this time. Ball tipped over the net. Iran have their side out.
Block out has been successful. Iran now moving a little further away, 20-16.
Not the best of hits again from Mirzad, but it's over the top of the block, and then as they tried to defend it, they're saying I didn't touch it. Well, it didn't matter because it was dug out of play. Another carry. Well, if you're unbalanced as you go to play the ball, that can be construed as you then having to carry the ball to keep it in play. Lifting called against Brazil this time.
Ball takes a big deflection, lovely block out from Anderson. And 5 points the difference, 17-22. Iran just 3 points away from taking this second set. Lovely spike by Mirzad. He's picking up a few points, but it was deemed to be carried.
Well, the Iranian team look at the referee in bemusement, as does the coach. He's going to call a timeout. I think if you hit the ball and put backspin on it and you're spiking, I don't see how that can be called as a carry. Your arm is moving through the ball in one motion. It's not stopping. The ball isn't stopping in your hand. the Iranian team play professional sitting volleyball domestically in Iran. Saman El Hojaj is the most popular team where most of the players come from, as well as Fulad Tebriz and Ravankaran, and also Shadari. Bosnia-Herzegovina, also another country that has professional sitting volleyball. You can see why those two teams tend to dominate the sport. That is a dominating block from Iran.
Alipur to serve, 23-18. That's gone a long way out, so this now brings Iran within set point. The chance to go two sets to nothing up. Alipur to serve. There's a joust at the net. The point's going to be replayed.
It was a big hit and it has gone in. In fact, it caught the block on its way out. Another set point saved. Just caught the hands, didn't it? Of the defender, didn't catch the block. Alipur trying to claim it had gone long.
Well, the point has gone to Iran, and they now take the second set to take the lead. Two sets to nothing, 25-19.
As well as the professional leagues in Iran, Bosnia-Herzegovina, Brazil also play sitting volleyball. Most of the players here from CPSP plus Unilehu and also Panarayas. Which is why we've seen such a great standard of sitting volleyball. The sets do set two statistics. Service faults by Brazil more than Iran, and not quite as good with the spiking, but Iran 6-2, big difference at the net.
So Renato from Brazil to serve to get the third set underway. Iran currently leading by 2-0.
Nice start from Brazil, getting the block, getting the first point of this third set of what is a must-win set for them. Winner of this one goes through to play for the gold medal. The loser will be battling it out for bronze. Any part of the body's allowed. That one off the head of Levi. But he can't keep it in play any longer.
Well, lifting given against Levi as he desperately tried to get to this ball. There we are, the hips up. That's not allowed.
That was taking an extreme play to an extreme level.
Oh, Alapurian to serve, and it's gone long. Point to Brazil.
Brazil inviting the long serve by putting their passing unit pretty much on the 3 metre line. That was a very good serve, actually, right between Wellington and Anderson. Chiba. Brazil claiming they didn't touch anybody, but there was a net touch by Wellington. Also, it appeared to hit the libero as it went out. So the early start from Brazil cancelled out by the 3 points from Iran. Change is coming. Danielle onto court. And off goes Wellington. Touch given against Brazil. Just when they thought they had the point, Guimarães can't believe it. Well, that was a huge swing. And it was an error from Anderson, and so Brazil call the timeout. After leading 2-0, they find themselves 5-2 down. That's Mirzad at his best. There is no stopping this. Hitting that from the top of the antenna, around about the 2m15 mark. That's 1m15. The antenna is about a metre high above the net. And this time, Iran get block out, extend their lead.
So Alipur continues to serve. He's having a good run here, 7-2.
Well, he was calling for that particular play. A carry goes against Brazil as they tried to block the ball. It came back to them and then they carried it over the net. Technical timeout. Iran leading 8-2. They were 8-1 up in the last set. Brazil, though, were able to come back. Can they do the same here? So at last, Brazil have a point. It's been a long time coming. Oh, what a spike that was. I'll tell you what, he's not really going to turn around and say to Mirza, do you mind getting your hands on that? He's just going to say to him, OK, you get the next one if you don't mind, because that come right down the line, hit him right in the face.
Alapurian, I'm sure, would have felt that.
Well, the ball's travelling around about 70, 80 kilometres an hour. And I should imagine, actually, when Merjard's hitting the ball, probably going even harder than that. Lovely setting again. It's a nice speed and rhythm to the setting for Iran. And from the captain, Alapurian, uses the ball really well.
So block out off Mirzad's serve, at least it went in this time. Anderson off, Fabrico on. Couple of changes going on here.
And in comes De Souza, the captain, number 8. Fabrizio on to serve, he had a good serving run in the last set. They need him to do the same here.
Well, that finds a gap between the defence. Blocker's just unable to get to it. Over the defence. Nicely into the gap, Rodrigo. Well, he was on his way there, but just a little bit late. Lascari, 11-4.
Four touches against Iran. Good hustle from Brazil to keep that ball in play. Suspicion of a double touch as it went out to the captain. The play was allowed to continue. It's Brazil who take the point. Trying to make it happen at the moment, Brazil. Just have to be careful, they don't over-celebrate. They are a long way back here and trailing by 2-0.
Delhi serving, and it's 12-6. Nice spike, finds the ground inside the lines. And that's all that matters, it's 16-13-6. Big Delhi to go again. Well, that goes off Fabrizio over the back. Iran are going to take every point that's coming right now, especially the easy ones. There's the serve. Fabrizio just a little bit low with the body, didn't get his hands up quick enough.
Looked like a touch. Brazil are never going to admit to it, anything but. Referee didn't see it, no help from the lines judge. And so it's Brazil who have the point. What does a super slow-mo say? Ooh, it might well have caught the arm. Very difficult to tell. A couple couple more points here for Brazil. And just as they did in the second set, they got back to 9-14, got back to 10-14. Iran called the timeout then. Will they do it now if Brazil take another point? Defense by Brazil, but the spike's gone long.
Well left by the Iranians. Decision making has to be so fast.
It's the right idea to go to the line, just couldn't find it. The right part of the court. Double touch against Brazil. Technical timeout number two reached. Iran leading 16-9 and by two sets to love. Match stats so far, blocks 8-10. Iran with a couple more, four more digs. Four more aces and also four more service faults.
Army to serve, 16-9. Lovely blocking by Alipour. The arms are up just in time to make contact. Army will continue to serve at 17-9. Number 10 comes in and he's straight into the mix to serve at 10-17. Oh, keeps it in play. It looked like it went to ground. Well, Anderson moved across. Put his hands up to block, but it wasn't there. Ball managed to find a gap. So, number eight off, Lashkari, and in his place, Golestani. Alpurian to serve. Into the net this time, though. See the fist pumps coming from the Brazilians. Every point matters. There's a big spike from Alipour, and these are the spikes that matter now, taking it to 19-11. Just 6 points between them and the match, and a guaranteed medal. The winner of this will go through to the final for gold or silver. So Wesley on. Serviço. There's a big hit from Bigdeli looking for the deflection, and the Iranians are claiming that they had a touch. Well, let's have a closer look. Oh, was there a touch from Daniel? Well, it was close, too close to call. Brazilians have been given the benefit of the doubt.
Much to the annoyance of Iran.
Lovely block, but it goes straight out of play, doesn't manage. So Mehrzad out and Merovan in, and in to serve. Not more reliable in the serving position. So at 20-13. Oh, lovely block by the Iranians. Ali Pour off. Salehi on. Wow, we've had another block. Pretty much a repeat of the previous point. Zarahi absolutely timing that to perfection, getting his hands up just at the right moment. Timeout's been called.
Stats so far, it's the blocking that's the difference. We've hardly seen anything of Mehrzad for Iran in this third and what looks like to be the final set. It's been great distribution from the Iranian captain Davood Alipourian. Some great blocking and good defending that have been the difference here. There is a chance now for Brazil.
Brazil closing the score just a little, 16-22, and it's Anderson to serve. Timeout now being called by Iran, 22-16 in the third. They lead by 2 sets to nothing. Anderson to serve, 16-22. Oh, big attempt, didn't come off. Zarahi. So, change back now, we see Lashkari coming in to serve. And off goes Golestani. 23-16. Goes for the gap and this time finds it. Well, that now takes Iran to within 1 point of victory. They have 8 match points. Lashkari to serve. Well, not to be on that match point. Brazil save one.
What a great position for Iran to be in now, though. Just needing side out to get this one done. Play on, third time lucky maybe for Iran in this rally. Great up from Anderson.
And they've done it. What a huge performance from Iran, taking the match by 3 sets to nothing. 25-17 in the last and going through to the final in the men's sitting volleyball. The Rio 2016 Paralympic Games guaranteed a medal. Will it be gold? Will it be silver?
Well, it was a really good start from Brazil. They really got into it. They really tried to make things happen in that first set. They then found themselves in a really tricky position in set two, being 8-1 down, but clawed it back and got into it, losing to 19. And then again in set three, ending up 8-2 down. Always going to be difficult. And you have to congratulate Iran. It wasn't just about Merzad. It was a team performance. They were the better team. Come the end of this one, winning by 3 sets to nothing, 25, 20, 19, and then 17 to book their place in the final. Brazil, well, they won't be competing for gold or silver, but they will be competing for bronze, and they will have a full house here, no doubt, at Rio Centro for that game. This is how it was done. Spike down the line. Not catching anybody, not catching the court. And the handstand celebration as Iran knew they'd book their place in the final. That's a nice touch from the Brazilian team as we see the confirmation of the score, just celebrating and the